In our previous section, we have seen how React element object is going to look like for different compositions, and we have inspected its elementary also. Then we understood components are nothing but entities that accept props as input and returns React elementary as output. We have also seen an overview on how React parses the React element object and creates the actual mapping of DOM nodes before it renders them onto the screen. Finally, it's understood that React element is simply a plain JavaScript object describing a DOM node or a component and its desired properties. In this section, let's discuss on component instance and how it is associated with the component. Before that, for starters, let's understand what's actually an instance in general. For that, let's say I have a person function constructor with some data properties inside it. The same can be replicated using ES6 class like this. You can leave it for now. We'll have an extended discussion on ES6 classes in our coming sections. For now, let's believe that these two are the same. Over here, I'm creating a SAM object of our person class or function constructor using new operator. So SAM object will now contain all the data members initialized that I defined here inside person. Or I can say here, SAM is an instance of person class or function constructor. So an instance in JavaScript is simply an object created from a class or function constructor. That's it. Since instances are being created from our component in React, they are termed as component instances. So we use the terms instance and component instance loosely here. One important thing to note, if I refer to component instance, I mean class components instance, because functional components don't have any instances at all. They are just invoked like a normal function in JavaScript by passing props to them. To be more specific, an instance refers to this object, what we are using inside our class component. It is useful for storing local data inside the component. Class components can be used to create any number of instances, and each of them will separately get their own this object or local state. To make the things clear, let's see it in action through code. Let me switch back to my code editor. I'm gonna navigate to my index.js file over here inside shows app, and let's make a slight bit of change over here so that instead of rendering single show, we can render multiple shows. I'm gonna go ahead and create a functional component by name shows like this. It's a function. And since it's a component, I have to return some JSX code. So let me write a return statement over here. Okay. And it can accept shows array from outside through its props. So let me define props. Okay. And inside its body, I'm gonna create an element of show component in JSX like this. Okay. And I'm gonna create a shows prop and set its value to props.shows. That is to whatever shows it's received from outside. I'm gonna initialize another prop, showIndex, and set its value to 0, asking our show component to start displaying from this particular show inside the array. Okay, since I want to render multiple show components, I'm duplicating this line 2 more times. And since I'm returning multiple React elements, I have to wrap them inside a div. So I'm gonna cut them and I'm gonna create a new div element and I'm gonna paste the code over here. Okay. Now, to our render method's first argument, instead of directly passing show components element, I'm gonna pass an element of shows functional component. And let's pass shows array as prop as it is. And I don't need this show index prop for now because I'm already doing it there. Okay, let's save it and move on to our browser. We can successfully see three shows are being rendered to the web page. To prove that all three are different and independent instances, let's try clicking on next show button on each of them. We can observe here all three instances are capable of showing three different shows at a time. This is because all three show instances have their own individual state object through which it keeps track of the show index. If they were sharing the same show index state, then all the shows would have rendered the same show here, but it didn't happen because they all have their own state objects. Okay. When we use show component three times here in JSX, React, or precisely React DOM, creates three different instances of show component, each having their own state. So that's the advantage of an instance. They enable us to store local data of the component. Now that we understood what's a component instance and how component and component instance are associated through code, let's try to understand this with a real world example to further cement them in our mind. Okay, how do we create muffins? I'm not talking about its recipe here, but the final product that we'll get. We go to the market, buy a muffin machine, and we keep reusing the same muffin machine to produce more and more muffin instances with different ingredients. You can think of muffin machine as a component, which is a blueprint. Muffins themselves as instances and ingredients as props. Let's just look at one more example. If you have noticed, design of buildings or blueprints gets prepared before the start of actual construction. Let's take a building with multiple apartments. You'll notice that layout and structure of all the apartments in a building looks identical. This is because before people start the construction of building, architects first prepare a blueprint of how the apartment will look like. Then they use that same blueprint to create several apartments in a building. You can think of our component as the same. Blueprints or the design is our component, and the constructed house, or in our case, the one that gets rendered to the DOM, is the component instances. You can think of component as a factory that can create several instances of the component that eventually returns React elements which gets rendered to the DOM. In JavaScript terms, component, or precisely class component, is just a function constructor or a class that we use to create objects of the type of component. Also, all the apartment structure may look same from outside because they created from the same blueprint. But in each apartment, one can have their own furniture or television. Similarly, all the instances may look same on the web page since they are created from the same component. But the data they render can be different since each component instance has its own local data. Okay, so you can recognize class components are more powerful than functional components because of the added capacity to store some data inside them, and each of its instance gets a own copy of that data. On the other hand, functional components are stateless functions that can't store any data inside them. React treats them as normal functions and hence just invokes them with props as argument. It is important to note that we don't create any instances of components by writing them in JSX. It's the renderer, which is React DOM in our case, creates an instance of the component. We just tell React that we want to use component show in our app by using JSX or React.create element. This is definitely one of the most common misconceptions that class component, when passed to React.create element or written in JSX like this, creates an instance of the component. It certainly doesn't. It just creates a React element of our component with type the component name, referring to our class component. And internally, React creates an instance of it if it's being rendered for the first time. Then on every subsequent render, it updates the same instance rather than creating a new one each time. Let me explain it using the code what we have written. For example, when our show component gets rendered for the first time, with this chunk of code over here, React creates an instance separately for each of title, poster, and show info because they are class components. Then on every next show button click, since we are updating state through set state, render method gets called again. And the previous instance created for each of title, poster, and show info is not destroyed. It's just updated. In this case, props associated with these instances gets updated. To reiterate again, React creates a component instance only once for a class components type element, and that's on for the very first render. Then afterwards, it keeps on updating the same instance with new data and renders whatever the React element that's been returned from the component's render method. Okay, it's just like if we want to change the furniture of our house, then we don't create or move to a new house for that with new furniture. It's sufficient to replace the furniture of our old house itself. Similarly, in React also, instance remains same and its data gets updated as needed. The next important thing that I want you to observe is, let me navigate into my code editor again. Here, I'm creating elements of three different types of components. This one is creating a primitive element div. And this one is creating an element of class component show. And finally, this one is creating an element of functional component shows. But we are not distinguishing by any means while writing them in JSX in the process of creating a React element from them. Whatever the component is, we are wrapping them inside JSX self-closing tag if they have no children, like here. And with opening and closing tags to contain some children, like in our div tag here. We also pass props the same way to each of them. So there is absolutely no difference between how we use a DOM element and how we use user-defined components. JSX is providing an uniform interface to create a React element, and the React element object structure is also the same, independent of element type. React further distinguishes on how to process that element according to its type. It hides away all the complexities of invoking functional component, creating, updating, and destroying instances of class component, and creating DOM nodes using a very simpler React element object. This is what declarative programming is. We don't need to worry about the complexity of DOM elements, functional or class components. all we need to do is to just provide React element to React using uniform JSX syntax, and React will do everything for us behind the scenes. You can think of React element as just an abstraction or description of the component or DOM elements. We use this abstraction everywhere with DOM elements and with user-defined components also. Okay, another point to note here, since everything is a React element, we can compose DOM elements, class components and functional components in different ways by simply using JSX. Just like how we are composing a user-defined components element inside a primitive element div. There are few more things still left to talk about React element, but I think this much of information is sufficient for now. We'll come back and revisit this section when we discuss reconciliation, or old term virtual DOM, in our to-do app. Okay, before wrapping it up, let's quickly go through what we have learned so far. A component is like a blueprint that takes props and finally tells React what it wants to render to the DOM, using a declarative way called React element. An instance is what we refer to as this inside the component class we write. It is useful for storing local state. React, or precisely React DOM, creates instances of class components that can contain and operate on their own state data. For example, we define show component once, but we can use it to create several instances of show component, each having its own show index property. And functional components don't have instances at all. They are just invoked by React like a normal function by sending props to them as argument. And just like any component, they return React element or React element tree as output. And be it a primitive element or a component, we represent in the same way using JSX. It will create the same React element's object structure. And internally, React processes the element according to its type. This uniform declarative syntax of React element is what makes React really easy to use. React element is just a way to tell React declaratively about what our component is composed of and what props it needs to represent in a JavaScript object. Finally, this diagram explains how our component, instance, and React element are connected to each other. I'm describing it by taking an example of title component. Title being a class component here, React DOM creates an instance of title component on its first render. Then it sets this.props property for the instance. And finally, just like functional component, React invokes render method of component instance to get the React element or React element tree. And then on subsequent re-renders, it keeps the same instance, but just updates its data and calls render method, which returns a new React element object, and that will get eventually rendered on the web page. So React element gets created for every render, but component instance gets created only for initial render. And that's how component, component instance, and React element are connected with each other. I know this is a kind of huge information to process in the initial phase of the course itself, but since I have been and I will be using these terms as we go on, it's better to clear the air surrounding them here itself, rather than delegating it further. In case if you find it difficult, don't worry. It all makes sense when we work on a couple of applications. So have patience and faith, and revisit this section when you feel comfortable with React concepts. Still, there are so many concepts in React which requires a detailed explanation, and we will explore all of them one by one through our upcoming applications. But I hope understanding these ground level concepts will establish a good foundation on how React works internally, rather than just blindly assuming something. Alright, let's carry on further. There are few more things still left to discuss about React element, but I think this much of information is sufficient for now. We'll come back and revisit this section when we discuss on reconciliation, or its old term, virtual DOM, in our to-do app.